People love a good scandal, and the poker world is no different. While we all love hearing about the latest tournament winners or the latest innovations in the game, the scandals and scams of the poker world tend to get the greatest overall attention. What is up, guys? Max here from Poker Bounty, bringing you today some of the most biggest and baddest scandals and scams of the poker world so far. Number 1. Absolute Bet and Ultimate Bet Super User Scandals. Perhaps the most famous case of online cheating in the history of online poker, this scandal dates back to September of 2007 when players started accusing the site of having super user accounts. This is obviously every poker player's worst nightmare. With the online game still only in the region of 10 years old, it was looking like the whole shebang was about to come collapsing down around us. If it was happening in one place, then it could be happening everywhere potentially. We'd heard of God mode in computer games, and we did not expect to see it in poker. A well-known high-stakes reg named Crazy Marco had lost heads up to Pot Tripper in a $1,000 buy-in tournament and suspected foul play. He then contacted the support team requesting the hand history for further analysis and got more than he bargained for. Support sent him the full history, including all hole cards for all the players. Pot Tripper's history showed irregular play. When analyzed by professional mathematician and gaming expert, he was shown to have played poker, which is just too perfect. Bluffing every time his opponents was weak, and making hero fold after fold. It was just too good to be normal. Within a month, the owners had to come clean, admitting their security had been breached. Although they initially had to attempt to skirt around the issue, claiming it was just a computer nerd employee trying to prove a point. Four accounts, including Pot Tripper, had all been banned and were confirmed as belonging to the same player. Another month later, we saw clarification that over a period of 40 days, $1.6 million had been defrauded from other players and would be returned as soon as possible. Fast forward to September of 2008, and finally, the villain was unmasked. The Kanwake Gaming Commission stated it had clear evidence that 1994 WSOP main event winner Russ Hamilton was behind the whole thing. But it wasn't only $1.6 million that had to be repaid. An in-depth investigation uncovered more than $22 million worth of fraud. The money did get repaid to the affected players, but it took a while for everybody's paranoia to settle. Number 2. Black Friday. Almost everyone knows the story. On 11th of April 2011, the US Department of Justice indicted PokerStars, Full Tilt Poker, and Absolute Poker on violations of the UIGEA and operations on illegal gambling business. 11 defendants were named as part of that indictment. Two out of the three sites went out of business because of Black Friday. Absolute Poker's parent company filed for bankruptcy and hasn't been heard from again. Full Tilt squandered nearly $400 million in worldwide deposits and shut down as well. The only company that paid their players was PokerStars. Later, PokerStars settled with the Department of Justice for $731 million. As part of that settlement, they received the assets of Full Tilt Poker and agreed to repay Full Tilt Poker players. The global online poker landscape changed forever that day. Many players lost their livelihoods or were forced to change their career path. Some lost everything, at least financially, that day. Many were able to recover, especially after the Full Tilt reimbursements. Others were forced to leave the game altogether. Number 3. The Original Multi-Accounting Scandal. While there had been many players accused of multi-accounting over the years, the first instances of players getting caught at playing with multiple accounts happened back in 2006. The first and still one of the most famous cases of multi-accounting was discovered in February of 2006 when Josh Field played the $500,000 Sunday tournament on Party Poker under two accounts. He played that event under the accounts of JJ Prodigy and a black car, and subsequently won the event under the latter. Field was able to exploit a flaw in the program that allowed you to open multiple windows and log in with multiple accounts. Field actually bragged about playing with multiple accounts during the event, which led to the investigation. Party Poker closed a black car account and confiscated over $180,000 in funds. It was later revealed that he had several accounts on Party Poker. After the JJ Prodigy scandal, online poker rooms started cracking down on players, and Justin Bonomo was the next major player caught multi-accounting. Playing primarily under Z Justin, he was multi-accounting on both Party Poker and PokerStars. He had 6 accounts on Party Poker and used all 6 to enter a single tournament. Party Poker confiscated over $100,000 from this account. PokerStars would later revoke funds from this account and used those funds to repay the players potentially harmed by his actions. Justin Bonomo was subsequently suspended from Party Poker and PokerStars, and Field was banned from majority of online poker rooms. the path that the players took afterwards was drastically different. Justin Bonomo quit his multi-accounting and went on to rehab his image. PokerStars later reinstated his account in 2009. Field, on the other hand, has been involved in multiple scandals over the years and even was slapped with a live tournament ban by PokerStars. He's presently banned from the most major online poker rooms with little chance of ever getting it reinstated. Number 4. Lock Poker. Lock Poker is unfortunately a throwback to the dark days of online poker. The site went down in April of 2015 after 2 years of complaints from players over lack of payment. According to reports, the site hadn't processed payments to players for a year prior to the closure. Lock Poker's owner, Jen Larson, is partially blamed for the demise. According to reports, Larson was funding her lifestyle with player funds. Other issues included difficulties in retaining decent payment processors and constant network changes. Lock Poker shut down, owing anywhere from $15 to $24 million to players. Many of the former Lock Poker pros are still being ostracized for their past association, including former WSOP Main Event champion Annette Oberstadt. Number 5. Isildur 1 suffers massive loss. The mysterious Isildur 1, later revealed to be Victor Blom, exploded on the high-stakes online poker scene in late 2009 when he ran up over $16 million in earnings. His swings after that time were epic, including a $4.2 million loss to Brian Hastings on December 8, 2009. This was the single greatest single-day loss by a player and the single greatest single-day win by a player in online poker history. It was later discovered that Brian Hastings, Brian Townsend, and Cole South had worked together to devise a strategy against Isildur 1. They data mined over 30,000 of his hands, and that information ultimately led to Isildur 1's massive loss. This stirred tremendous controversy over the issue of data mining of players' hands, and Townsend actually had his Full Tilt Red Pro status suspended for 30 days following this incident. Data mining had remained an issue among online poker players, and many sites are now taking steps to limit data mining. Unfortunately, those steps won't help Isildur 1 recover his $4.2 million loss. Number 6. Prior to 2019's end, the first major cheating scandal in a decade was discovered. Mike Possel, a low-stakes grinder at Stones Gambling Hall in Northern California, was accused of cheating during the Stones Live livestream cash game show. The scandal started at the end of September when Veronica Brill, a former employee of the Stones Gambling Hall in Sacramento, took to Twitter and posted several tweets about the possible cheating going on at live events. Joey Ingram went on to investigate various Stones Live poker streams on his YouTube channel, and backing this up, Duck Polk also took to his account on YouTube to further analyze the allegations. The first reaction of Stones Gambling Hall was to wave the issue aside, as it announced that the company already carried out an investigation into the matter and there was no evidence that pointed to any form of cheating at any of its events. While appearing in Mike Matisau's podcast, Mike Possel insisted that he was innocent and that the numbers that people were using on his winnings were simply off. Many have speculated that Mike Possel had received information about the hold cards of his opponents during the cash games, which was why he was able to win so much at such a rate. Both Possel and Stones Gambling Hall denied the allegation. However, they are being now sued for a sum of $10 million in class action lawsuit by Possel's opponents and their counsels. Number 7. Jamie Gold stiffs back $6 million. In 2006, Jamie Gold won the largest World Series of Poker main event in history for $12 million. Prior to the main event, Gold had signed a contract with Bodog.com Entertainment to find celebrities to play in the event. Jamie Gold partnered with Crispin Laser for this job, and in exchange for services rendered, Gold was to receive his entry into the main event and split his winnings. Gold went on to win the main event in epic fashion, but when it came time for him to settle up with Laser, he decided to keep the $12 million all for himself. Laser would later sue Gold and was able to successfully block Gold from receiving $6 million of his winnings while the matter played out in court. Jamie Gold and Laser would settle their matter in early of 2007. This settlement came after a US Circuit Court judge refused to block the restraining order against the $6 million because he felt the Laser was likely to prevail in the case. Number 8. Counterfeit chips in the 2014 Borgata Winter Open. Back in January of 2014, the opening event of the 2014 Borgata Poker Winter Open was suspended and subsequently cancelled after the discovery of counterfeit chips. The event had a $2 million guarantee and top price of $372,000. Christian Lizardi was ultimately identified as the culprit. After busting out of the event, Luzzardi got nervous and tried to dispose of his remaining counterfeit chips by flushing them down a toilet. He had over 500 chips in his room, totaling over $2 million. His attempts to get rid of those chips clogged up the plumbing of Harrah's Casino Hotel and led to his quick arrest. Luzzardi was sentenced in October of 2015 to 5 years in prison. He must also pay restitution of $463,000 to the Borgata and $9,500 to Harrah's. Chances are they won't ever see a dime of it because he owes over $1.1 million in restitution for a different conviction from running an international DVD bootleg operation. Number 9. Pitbull Poker. For those who are new to poker, you may not have heard of the controversy surrounding Pitbull Poker. The site ran from 2004 to 2009 and was originally a no-download site. This small site was famous for bonus users, but things quickly went south once super users were discovered on the site. At least 3 super user accounts were discovered on the site, and there were multiple documented instances of pot shaving. For those unfamiliar with the term, pot shaving is when a portion of the pot disappears in addition to the standard rake collected by the site. Pitbull Poker shut down for good on September 29, 2009, when employees at the Costa Rican office were told to take their night off for building maintenance. Some became suspicious and went back to the office to discover the site owners loading equipment into a moving truck. It is unknown at this time how much money the site actually stole from players, but the site still serves as a cautionary tale about the online poker's dark days. Number 10. The Void disqualified after winning 2007 W Coupe main event. In 2007, The Void defeated 2,998 players to win the W Coupe main event title and $1.37 million. The account was owned by Natalie Telscher, the sister of poker pro Mark Telscher. Some players complained that it was Mark that was playing and not Natalie, and PokerStars began the investigation. It was later determined that Mark had been multi-accounting on PokerStars under several aliases, including The Void. They subsequently disqualified The Void, and everyone moved up one space in payouts. This included Vanessa Russo, who moved from third to runner-up, earning over $700,000. Natalie Telscher later tried to sue PokerStars over the disqualification, but she later admitted that she had an agent playing under her account for her. This put her in violation of PokerStars' terms of service, and she withdrew her lawsuit. Number 11. Collusion of Jean-Paul Pasqualini and Cedric Rosi in the Poker Tour 2009. Two or more players working together is the stuff of legends. The iconic movie Rounders actually showed a version of this and how cheaters work and the painful results it can bring. In 2009, French poker players Jean-Paul Pasqualini and Cedric Rossi took over $2 million from employing some elaborate poker cheats. Careful inspection of the video revealed that the players were touching parts of their heads and faces to signal their cards to each other throughout the final table. Although they were eventually found out, the players kept their prize money, which amounted to 1 million euros and 600,000 euros for the respective first and second place finishes. The Global Poker Index suspended both players from the poker rankings, however, they are now recognized as cheats. So those were some of the biggest online and live poker scams and scandals so far. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like, subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.